A high-level delegation of South Sudan rebel groups, ESPLM and ESPLA, led by the deputy chairman, General Alfred Ladu, flew to Uganda to meet the Ugandan top leadership. The meeting was not part of the peace talks. According to the rebels' press statement, the meeting would answer a long-term quest by the Ugandan president to discuss with the rebels. Earlier today, the Foreign Affairs Ministry denied knowledge of the presence of the rebels in Uganda. This, however, leaves some unanswered questions. A document from SPLM spread on Sunday confirming a meeting between the rebels and top Uganda government officials. James Radet is the spokesperson SPLM. In a telephone interview this afternoon, Radet told Urban TV that the delegation was disappointed.
Our delegation went to Kampala with the understanding that they are going to meet the President Museveni. Unfortunately, nobody received them at the airport, and they stayed there for the whole day. What I have just seen, the statement coming out from the Ugandan government, is that their visit was not well coordinated. I don't understand what that means, because they knew that the delegation was coming for the purpose of meeting the Ugandan leadership.
The rebels, however, insist they want the restoration of peace in South Sudan to relieve the nationals of the unrest that started over 6 months back. Radet says it's now up to Uganda, as the rebel group is open to peace talks.
I think the ball is in the court of the Ugandan government if they are serious to dialogue with our movement. I think they will tell us what is the way forward, because the way forward for us was to go to them and talk, but since they did not receive us, I think they will tell us what to do next.
In what could be echoes of continued and even serious fighting in South Sudan, the South Sudanese ambassador to Uganda accused Riek Machar forces of conspiring with warlord Joseph Kony to destabilize Africa's youngest nation, and implicitly said his government will return fire for fire.
Riek Machar is now teaming up with Kony to fight South Sudan. This is what it is. This is not a secret. Riek Machar is teaming up with the Kony so that he gets his way back to destroy Uganda too. That's what it is. And the Kony's son is also there, who is actually leading also this particular war.
So yes, more violence may occur because the government is preparing for it. And we will not sit back and allow ourselves to be loitered. We will definitely defend.
As the fighting in South Sudan continues, Uganda is paying part of the cost. We do not know the cost of the South Sudanese war on the budget because information concerning the military is classified. But we can assume that the cost of the war has been big since December, when over 1,500 UPDF troops went to the mission in South Sudan. There has also been lack of coordination from official utterances by the South Sudanese government on who is incurring the cost. The South Sudanese foreign minister said his government meets the cost of the war, including the presence of the Ugandan army forces. But yesterday, President Salva Kiir's envoy to Uganda gave a contradicting remark.
Mobility is very important in South Sudan for even our own army to move around. And therefore, if the UPDF are there in South Sudan also, because we call them there and we do not want them to get stuck somewhere, why not to give them the fuel? Why not give them the fuel in order for them to move around? We don't invite them there to get stuck, because we invite them there to be part and parcel of the people whom we have been together as friends, as one people.
The rebels launched an offensive last weekend to recapture its former headquarters in Nasil town, which was seen as the most serious resumption of hostilities. The rebels are currently in Ethiopia awaiting the resumption of the peace talks.